Hello you guys and welcome to VideoTalk. Today I will be talking you about my personal favorite film and one of the best movies ever made, Scarface. So say hello to my little friend. So Scarface was directed by none other than Brian De Palma, and it was made in year 1983, and it was produced by Marty Breckman for Universal Studios. It's a remake of the film by same name, which was made in the year 1932. So perhaps it's appropriate to talk first about this original Scarface. First item in my Scarface collection, it is Arpinaama Scarface, a VHS tape from Finland released by Castle Video. It's Mr. K.I. This has been a library copy, you can tell about this ugly sticker, which doesn't fucking come off. These things don't fucking come off no matter what. And I don't know anybody else who has this Mr. K.I. release. Maybe this was only sold to the libraries. I don't know. I don't know about that. And guess what? I just watched this for the first time last night. Holy shit! I mean, I have seen Scarface 83 version like a fucking million times since I was fucking 15 years old. But this, I didn't watch it, goddammit. But the 4K disc, which I will be showing you later, it includes the Scarface Blu-ray and I watch it. So this is set in the probation and no cocaínos there. So Paul Muni, excellent Paul Muni, plays Tony Camonte, the guy who gets in the booze business, and soon enough he takes care of his competition and even his own boss. The film hits pretty much the same plot points than the 83 film, but, well, I was watching it and I was thinking to myself, yeah, this includes much more action than the 1983 version, and the 1983 version is much more focused on the internal conflict of Tony Montana and his gang and his relationship with his partners. But whereas this film is much more focused on the gang wars which raged there. And yeah, for a film, for a 1930s film, it includes a lot of killing and shooting. No wonder this was banned in Finland, but released somewhere in the 80s or something like that. I did enjoy watching it and I would give it 3 stars, but if I compare it to the 1983 version, there's no question about that if it's better. Yes siree. Here we have Al Pacino starring in Scarface, directed by Brian De Palma from year 1983. Where to begin? This is so over the top 80s film, 80s action crime drama, you know. It's a comic book film. Al Pacino is so fucking bonkers. He's so over the top character, and Brian De Palma knows this. He knows how to direct this kind of a film, and the Oliver Stone script, come on, it just makes these guys go crazy. Everybody goes crazy in this cocaine-fueled action extravaganza. Fuck Casper Gomez and fuck the fucking Diaz brothers! Fuck them all, yes! This film also included the highest F-bomb count at the time. And the first time I saw it, it was Finnish TV and I was fucking blown away. I was so fucking blown away, like I got this catharsis out of it. You know, when you see a good film with bloody final end fight, films like Wild Bunch or Better Tomorrow or Hardboiled or Killer from John Woo, and then you finish the film and you just say, my god, it was like I was in the shower, I purified. It's called catharsis. And this is one of those rare films which still gives me that kind of a cathartic feeling. And the music by Giorgio Moroder, it's a classic. Giorgio Moroder did some soundtracks before. He did Midnight Express and American Gigolo before this, at least. But this, I think, is his magnum opus. Come on, Elvira's theme. Push it to the limit! Come on, push it to the limit! It's so good of a song that I asked my friend Karo to make a cover of it for my Finnish YouTube channel. And let's hear it now. Oh, that's some rocking tunes, eh? And yeah, one more thing. Yes, back in 2010, I visited Miami, and yes, sirree, I went to see the location where they filmed this hotel scene which this Tony Montana's pal, Angelo, gets killed with a chainsaw. It was Ocean Drive something, this hotel, and it looked pretty much very different than it looks in the film, but that is about the only filming location that I have ever visited, so this is a very important film to me. So now I will present you my Scarface collection. First we have, of course, the VHS. Released by Sick Video, SL the Video labels, and it's a K-18 version, which means no, it's not for under 18 year old people. And this is actually the same version, the cinema version, which was shown in the cinema screens back in the 1980s in Finland. And imagine this, it's uncut, because in Finland we enjoyed with this very tight censorship. It involved cinemas and videos, but for some reason, I guess the censors in Finland liked this and thought it was realistic film and whatnot, and important film, so they passed this uncut. So therefore, this video release is also uncut. Nice looking yellow covers, and I do like this original artwork. I don't know why in the later versions they have, you know, blur, you know, drawn out Michelle Pfeiffer, because it kind of nicely represents the yin and yang of this character and of this film too. But then came the video law. Back in the year 1987, it was the year of doom for the Finnish movie video enthusiast. Our government passed a law which made all home recordings subject to the censorship law. Before that, it was like a Wild West, because basically everybody could release anything. But then came the Finnish Board of Film Classification. They started to examine the films that were released, and they started to butcher them off. So therefore we get this K-16 version. Evil video law basically banned every K-18 film for home video release. So this SL the Video had to release this again with K-16 marking, and compared to this, this is poorly cut. This is like cut like 50 seconds or something. How badly they fucking raped this film, which is my favorite film. Damn you to hell. Yeah, let me show you.
Take him out here, wait.
Chi-Chi. Get the Yale. Chi-Chi, get the Yale. Okay. That's the uncut. Okay, I guess he died. So fuck Casper Gomez and fuck the fucking Finnish video law! Fuck them all! So naturally, the times change and this thing got released on DVD, and of course that was uncut, and I got the DVD, I don't have it anymore, sorry. And then came the Blu-ray, and I don't have that either anymore, but this This baby here is the current version of this magnificent part of cinema. Yes, this is the gift set 4K release of Scarface. And let's see. Here we have the Scarface on 4K. And also, of course, this is the 4K. And of course, we have the Blu-ray. And then we have the Paul Muni 30s version of this. And because it's a gift set, we have this magnificent replica of Tony Montana statue. The world is your statue. It's great. And this 4K release of the film is also very beautiful, beautifully mastered. The HDR really brings the Miami city life, the greens, the yellows, the sunsets. It really brings the film live, because Brian De Palma said in this commentary, by the way, this includes all the previous extras, the great making of documentary, and also it includes a new extra when this old cast and crew is having this panel discussion. It was shot in 2019 or something, and it's fantastic to see Michelle Pfeiffer. She's very hot, still very hot. And Al Pacino, of course, sharing his thoughts about the making of the film. Yeah, but Brian De Palma said that he wanted this film to look as bright and colorful as possible. And no, like this film noir style film, like the first original film is. But he wanted to show the Miami, which does bathe in color. So this kind of a film is a perfect match for HDR and 4K mastering. But my Scarface collection does not limit itself for only movies. No siree. Here you see my Scarface towel. I got this from Miami. Like I said, I visited there back in 2010. And also, I have a Scarface puzzle. I have not ever assembled it, but I got this as a birthday present from my pal Raul. So this is a nice souvenir, but maybe someday when I get retired, I will open this box of pieces and start compiling this Scarface. Great looking picture. Come to think of it, I've never actually opened this before, so imagine if this would have been filled with cocaine. That would be so awesome. And speaking of games, I have here Scarface Nintendo Wii game. It has been so long time since I played this. I don't have an operational Wii anymore. But I remember that this was sort of like a Grand Theft Auto style game. It is set after the final fight in the film, and somehow you recover from all those bullets, and then you start rebuilding your empire as Scarface. And what was funny about this, that this like a Al Pacino imitator is making all these kind of Scarface quotes when you walk around the street and you go pushing the people and then go fuck yourself, go fuck yourself, fuck off, fuck off. So clearly this game has a pretty foul language. But what is kind of bummer, you cannot shoot innocent bystanders and you can't run over them with a car. So that's kind of a bummer if you're used to GTA. Antics, so it's a letdown. But yeah, game, gotta have it.
Okay, man.
So that was my Scarface collection. Tell me in the comments what did you think of it, and leave a like if you like it. And remember to subscribe the channel as usual. And let me leave you with a quote from the film that you might recognize. You need people like me. You need people like me so you can point your fucking fingers and say, that's the video guy. So say goodnight to the video guy. Come on, say goodnight to the video guy. And subscribe to the channel. Come on. So thanks for watching and catch you in the next video. And the next video will be doing something with these. Bye bye. First you get the VHS, then you get the DVD. And then you get the 4K. First you get the DVD. First you get the VHS. Then you get... First you gotta get the VHS. Then you get the DVD. And then you get the 4K Ultra HD.